Now let's start with the chapter hormones. Now before starting this chapter and what do you mean by hormones, how these are classified and everything. Now let's see what hormones are saying to us. Think that hormones are speaking and what they said, we are the chemical messengers of the body. We are the chemical messengers of the body, diversified in our structure and functions, act either directly or through messengers, growth, health and welfare is our motto. So in four lines we can define hormones. So you will understand all these four lines when we will go through the definition, classification and functions of the hormones. I am repeating these four lines again. We are the chemical messengers of the body, diversified in our structure and function, act either directly or through messengers, growth, health and welfare is our motto. So let's discuss what hormone means by hormone. Now, in this picture, you can see that this is one gland, this yellow color. It is one gland and here, this is called as specialized gland or secreting cell, which are also called as endocrine gland. In this picture, if you can see, these endocrine glands are secreting purple color balls. Okay. So, these purple color balls are nothing but hormones. And this red color, it is a vessel, blood vessel. So, these endocrine glands are secreting a small organic compounds in the bloodstream through the blood vessel and through this blood vessel, these are going towards the new cell, which is also called as a target cell or specific receptor. Here we can see this cell also, but as this cell is not a target cell, it is not a receptor of hormone. So hormones are not going towards these wrong receptors. They are going towards the proper receptor where they can perform their function. So we can say that hormones are secreted through some specialized glands. Those are called as endocrine glands. They enter into the bloodstream and through the blood, they go towards the target cell or specific receptors. It means hormones are secreted at one place and they perform their function at other place. So based on that, we can define hormones. So now let's see the introduction and definition of hormone. The living body possesses a remarkable communication system to coordinate its biological function. This is achieved by two distinctly organized function system. One we know nervous system, which coordinate the body functions through the transmission of electrochemical impulses, and another system is endocrine system, which act through a wide range of chemical messengers, and these chemical messengers are nothing but hormones. Hormones are the chemical messenger. This is the simplest definition of the hormone. But hormones are conveniently defined as organic substances which are produced in small amounts by specific glands or tissues known as endocrine glands, and these are secreted into the bloodstream to control the metabolic and biological activities in the target cell. Hormones are also considered as chemical messengers, which attack on the or act on the target cells. Now, these target cells are nothing but the specific cells that hormones act on. A single hormone can have many target cells, but each one can respond differently to the hormone. Not necessary that one hormone attack on act on only one receptor cell. So, a single hormone can have many target cells, but each one can respond differently to the hormone. Hormone work by binding to the receptor on or within the cell and changing the activity of that particular cell. We just saw that hormones are secreted from endocrine gland. They enter through the bloodstream and they act on the receptor. So, they bind the receptor and change the activity of that particular cell or the receptor. It is important to note that hormones do not intimate any reactions in their target cell. That is one of the most important thing. They never initiate any reaction in their target cell. They just change the activity of that particular cell. So, this is the introduction and definition of hormones. So, in simple way, we can say that hormones are secreted by endocrine gland. These are the organic compounds and which are the chemical messengers in the body, which send message from one part of the body to the other. Now, before starting about hormones, let's discuss what do you mean by endocrine glands and how many types of glands, endocrine glands present in the human body and what are their, which type of hormones they secrete. So, in this picture, you can see here, this is the human body and at different places, some specialized tissues or glands are there. These glands are endocrine gland. So, we can define endocrine gland as endocrine glands are glands of endocrine system that secrete their products, that is hormones, directly into the blood rather than through a duct. So, endocrine glands are ductless glands. They don't have any duct or pipe. They directly secrete their product hormone into the blood. So, endocrine glands are the glands of endocrine system that secrete their product, that is hormones, directly into the blood rather than through a duct. So, endocrine glands are ductless glands. Now, here in this diagram, you can see there are various types of endocrine glands present in the human body. Now, actually in our syllabus, there is not detailed study of endocrine glands. Only we just want to know, we just want to study the name of endocrine glands and the hormones secreted by these endocrine glands. Now, here you can see the first endocrine gland, it is hypothalamus. Now, hypothalamus is the master coordinator of hormonal action. It is the master. And as it liberates certain releasing factors or hormones that stimulate or inhibit the corresponding tropic hormones from their anterior pituitary. So, in a simple way, we can say that hypothalamus is the master of all the other hormones and it is present in the center of the brain. Hypothalamus is present here in the here it is present, hypothalamus. Now, hypothalamus produces mainly six releasing factors for hormone. One is TRH, that is TRH, it is a thyrotropin releasing hormone. Then CRH, that is corticotropin releasing hormone. Then GHRH, that is growth hormone releasing hormone, growth hormone releasing hormone. And another are dopamine, somatostatin and vasopressin. All these are the hormones secreted by hypothalamus. Why? Another is pituitary gland. You can see here pituitary gland. The pituitary gland is located just below the hypothalamus of the brain, and it consists of two distinct parts, like anterior pituitary and the posterior pituitary. Actually, posterior pituitary gland, this part is not present in the human beings, which is not very active in the human beings, and so here we can say that only anterior pituitary gland, it is working, and it is the master endocrine organ that produces several hormones which influences either directly or indirectly a variety of biochemical processes in the body. For instance, growth hormones are directly related to the pituitary glands, and it releases, one is GH, that is growth hormone, then another is TSH, that is thyroid stimulating hormone, then one is ACTH, that is adrenocorticotropic hormone, FSH, follicle stimulating hormone, LH, it is luteinizing hormone, and prolactin, oxytocin, vasopressin, all these are the hormones secreted by pituitary gland. One more, a very small gland is present in the lower part of the brain behind the hypothalamus, and that is the pineal gland, which secretes melatonin hormones. Now, another gland, which is the main major gland, that is a thyroid gland. Thyroid and parathyroid gland. This gland is located on either side of trachea. We can simply say that these are present in the neck part of the human beings. But properly, if you want to say, thyroid gland is located on either side of trachea, below the larynx, and it produces two principal hormones, that is T3 and T4. T3, that is a triiodothyronine, and T4 is tetraiodothyronine, which are primarily concerned with the regulation of the metabolic activity of the body. Goiter, if you have heard, goiter is a disorder caused by enlargement of thyroid gland and is mainly due to iodine deficiency in the diet. You may have seen that a big lump is produced near the throat or neck. It is called as goiter, and it is a disorder caused by this thyroid enlargement of thyroid gland. Then another hormone, sorry, gland, it is the thymus. These are thymopoietin. Actually, there are only six major glands. So, we will see liver is also there. Then, pancreas. This is one of the main gland which secretes insulin, glucagon and somatostatin. Then, adrenal cortex. This is one of the adrenal cortex. Actually, adrenal, it has two parts. Adrenal glands are two small organs located above the kidney. You can see above the kidney. So, one is called as cortex and medulla. Outer part is called as cortex and inner part is also called as medulla. So, adrenal cortex, it synthesizes four hormones, that is androgen, glucocorticoids, which is the major one, glucocorticoids that influence glucose, amino acid and fat metabolism, and mineral corticoids. It also secretes adrenaline and noradrenaline. While medulla, it produces two important hormones, that is epinephrine and norepinephrine, which are not written here, but it produces these two main hormones. Now, here you can see these are testes, ovaries and uterus. These are also called as gonads. And these testes, these are produces the steroid sex hormones. Testes are present in male and ovary, it is present in female, and they produces steroid sex hormones, primarily androgen in males, you can see here, and estrogen in females. These hormones are responsible for growth, development, maintenance and regulation of reproductive system in either sex, male or female. So, testes are present in male and ovaries which produce estrogen in female. Both the hormones are responsible for proper growth, development, maintenance and regulation of reproductive system in them. Now, several other gastrointestinal hormones are also there which we have not discussed here, like gastrin, then secretin, have been identified and that are closely involved in the regulation of digestion and absorption of foodstuffs. So, this is all about the endocrine glands.